So this is our first unit's content, where in first part we will be seeing in detail the dynamic memory allocation and pointers. In the second part we will be seeing in detail how to use pointers with arrays, matrices, with functions. And in third part we are going to implement file data structure. So file operations we will be doing. So what is exactly pointer? We are going to directly start with the pointers now, because I hope that all of you must have practiced C or basic structures. So if anyone has any problem, you can interrupt me, or you can we will have question answer session in the last 5 minutes. So pointers, they are powerful but difficult to master, because many students, they are afraid of using pointers. So we don't have to be afraid, but we have to be strong in using pointers, because this is the basic concept where the memory is getting utilized. How to utilize the memory properly, that is clear with the when we understand pointers in detail. So we have to work hard initially, but once the pointers concept is clear, you can apply it anywhere. Then you should simulate the call by reference. So in the last session also we have seen what is call by value, call by reference. And in call by reference, what we do, we pass actual memory location to the function, and we manipulate the original variable that we are going to see in detail. And pointers are useful with arrays and strings. They are having close relationship with arrays and string. Pointers help in using arrays and strings in the better way. How that we will see, and we have our first two or three assignments based on this thing only. We have to see in detail how pointers are manipulated and how they are useful in arrays and with structures, with files, etc. So we have to see arrays in detail. Now, what is the pointer? You must have used pointers. Where is it used in real life? It is like addresses in the phone book. So if you have one, suppose you have a contact and you have to find its address. So what you do is you first search for that name, and then that name will be having, it will be pointing to some of the address. So while searching in the directory or in the dictionary, what you do is you follow the pointers. Whenever you are using any index, that also is one of the example of pointers. In the index, what you do, you have certain topics and you have the page numbers. So those topics are diverting you to certain page number. That is nothing but it is a pointer. Then road signs, URLs for the web pages, they are nothing but the pointers. They are directing you to the required page. Then page number in the index, all these are the real-time examples of the pointers. Now, a pointer can have memory address of any variable type. It can be a primitive type, it can be pointing. That pointer will be helping us to manipulate arrays. It can be pointer to structure or union. Then it can be a pointer to dynamically allocated memory as per our requirement. We have allocated the memory dynamically and this pointer is pointing to that. It can be pointer to another pointer, or it can be a pointer to the function. Okay, so pointer can point any of these structures. Okay, and by the end of this unit, we have to learn using pointers in a for any of these structures. Okay. Now, why pointers? Why it is required? So, what are the different advantages you can think about using pointers? Why they are required? If they are difficult to manipulate, why they are in our syllabus, or why we are using the pointers? If you can perform certain applications without pointer also, why the pointers are required? So there are actually four advantages of using pointers. First is, pointers are useful for manipulation of the large data structures like arrays or databases. Okay, so arrays of numbers or arrays of structures, if it is a large database, if array of structure is representing a large database, then using pointer we can manipulate the database in the easier way. Okay, so pointers are used for pointing to the large data structures. That is one of the advantage. Second is they facilitate sharing between different parts of the program. So you must have used pointers in the function for call by reference, or we will be doing that in the assignments. Okay, so call by reference is very important applications of pointer. They facilitate sharing between different parts of the program. Okay, that is different units of the program, that is different functions. So what is shared in different functions? Memory. Same memory is accessed by different functions. They make it possible to get new memory dynamically as your program is running. So that is one of the that is one of the advantage, dynamic memory allocation. Okay, so as per our requirement, we can allocate the memory dynamically at runtime. They make it possible to easily represent the relationship between different data items. So for advanced data structures like linked list, stack, queue, tree, graph, etc., pointers are very much useful for building such advanced data structures. Okay, so we will be seeing linked list in detail in the next unit. Stack queue also we are going to learn, and tree graph nonlinear data structures we will be learning in the next part of the data structures, that is in next. So to build these advanced data structures, pointers are very much useful. So whenever anyone asks you about pointer, you should have these advantages of the pointer in your mind. Why to use pointers? It is useful in accessing large data structures, complex data structures, and call by reference, and for dynamic memory allocation. And because of these advantages, we are going to learn pointers in detail. So I know all of you must have gone through all these things where we have learned what is pointers. Pointer is nothing but memory address of any data structure. Okay. So I will not go through all this presentation in detail, because I know that you have attended the bridge course and where you have revised what is pointer. So it is nothing but pointer to or address of the memory allocated. Now we have seen how to differentiate between pointer and actual variable. So y equal to x, this is nothing but copy of that variable, and ampersand x is address of that variable. Okay, so this is value. Y is value of that particular variable, and ampersand x is nothing but the address. So all of we know this. So we discuss one of the example. Now here in this example, pointers are declared. P1 is integer pointer and P2 is character pointer. So how much memory is required for allocating P1 and P2? How much memory is required? And there is another pointer P3 which is an unsigned int. So can you comment on this in the chat box? How much memory is required for storing P1, P2 and P3, which are having different data types? Is it at least tell me whether it is similar, same memory is required for storing all this, or different memories? All are using P1 is 4 bytes, and what about P2, P3? Rudul Sairaj is saying 6 bytes of memory. Yash is saying same memory is required by all three pointers. Yes, so all the three pointers, they are using same memory. The answer is correct. And how much? That depends on what is the configuration of your system. Is it 32-bit और 64 bit कंप्यूटर. सो डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट इट विल वेरी. ओके, सो विल एज्यूम दैट वी विल हैव 64 bit मेमोरी. सो देर विल बी 8 bytes ऑक्यूपाइड फॉर एवरी पॉइंटर. ओके, सो वॉट एवर इज द डेटा टाइप फॉर विच योर पॉइंटर इज पॉइंटिंग, द पॉइंटर इज हैविंग सेम मेमोरी स्पेस. ओके, सो पी वन पी टू पी थ्री ऑक्यूपाई सेम मेमोरी स्पेस, दैट इज 8 bytes. एंड देन हाउ दे आर डिफरेंट, वाई दे आर डिफरेंट, वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस इंटीजर पॉइंटर, कैरेक्टर पॉइंटर, लाइक दैट. एनी वन कैन यू टाइप इन द चैट बॉक्स, वॉट इज द डिफरेंस, वाई देर इज डिफरेंट डेटा टाइप रिक्वायर्ड. Yes, Mridul, most of the computers are now 64-bit. You are right. Data type of variable. Yes, so this will tell the, you are correct, the data type of variable to which it is pointing. Okay, so int pointer means P1 will be able to point all the integers. Okay, P1 will be able to point integers. Then P2 will be able to point character, that is 1 byte, and P3 will be able to point unsigned int type of variable. Okay, so is it possible that I can say, suppose there is a character X. And can I say P1 is equal to ampersand X? Is it correct? Yes, if there is variable X which is of character type and my P1 is of integer pointer, so can I say that P1 is equal to ampersand X, or is it wrong? Will it be correct? Or will it be wrong? Yes. So suppose I have x is equal to int x is equal, okay, character x. Is it correct? Char x. Suppose I have char x and int pointer p1. And can I say p1 is equal to ampersand x? Is this statement correct? P1 is equal to ampersand x. Yes, there will not be any error. Okay, but what will be differing? The way in which we are treating that pointer, that will differ. Okay, so if your pointer is of the type integer, it will incrementing that pointer. So the pointer value will be incremented by one integer space, that is 2 bytes. Okay, or in 64-bit compiler, there will be incrementation will be of 4 bytes. Okay, if that character is suppose pointer is character type, then incrementation will be of 1 byte. Okay, so that tells the type of the pointer. It tells how you are going to treat that particular pointer. So we'll see those examples. Here, so here P1 is equal to ampersand X, where X is integer, then this is okay, and instead of ampersand X, we can say P1. So this all of us know, when we want to refer value, we will use asterisk sign. When we want to refer address, we will use ampersand sign. So here, what is the problem in this particular program? Can you find out any problem? So here, what is the problem? Here we have declared a variable, a pointer, and we are scanning p, but and we are saying p is equal to ampersand x. So what is the problem here? First we are using the pointer and then we are assigning. This is wrong. We have to first assign the value to the pointer and then we have to use that particular value. Okay, so that sequence is not correct. Okay, here, so all of we know the indirection, that is when we are assigning the value, what happens? Okay, so we declare the pointers in this way, int pointer, my ptr1, etc. Okay, yes, so in this particular program there is a variable y and pointer yptr, and this is initialization. So this is the sequence: declaration of pointer, assigning the value to the pointer and using it. Okay, so you have performed, I hope you have performed the practice of these two things. And one more important thing, asterisk and ampersand are inverses. They cancel each other out. So if I say ampersand point, sorry, pointer ampersand x, that means it is simply x, value of a variable x. So we'll go through certain examples here. Okay, this is simple. I is equal to 37. These are all variables stored in the array. Okay, array is starting from suppose 1000 and it is storing the variables. Okay, this is one of the array, character array A, B, C, D, A, B, C and slash 0. Okay, like this, suppose memory is there and I want to now say I is equal to 40. So like this, the memory is allocated. Okay, memory is allocated and every memory has some address and some value, which is stored in that memory. So if I say A of 2 is equal to Z, that A of 2, the address is referred and in that the value will be modified. Okay, so these are the very simple examples. You can go through it afterwards. I'll mail these PPTs. So we'll discuss some examples which are somewhat tricky. Okay, you know all these things. You can go through these examples. Okay, we'll discuss this example. I hope this is not discussed in Akshay's class, isn't it? This example is not discussed now. Shall I discuss this? Anyone? Just say yes or no. It is discussed? Okay, I'll go through it. Just see here, there are two pointers, pointer ptr and pointer pptr. And there are two variables I and j which are initialized to 5 and 10. Now, when we are at, here, we are initializing pptr to ampersand ptr. That is, this is double pointer. Okay, this is double pointer. So, when I am saying pointer ptr is equal to 3, which variable will be 3? It will be pointer ptr is storing reference of I. So, value of I will be now initialized to 3. So when we are at this statement, value of I will be 3 because PTR is storing address of I. Then when we are saying double pointer P PTR is equal to 7. So what is that double pointer P PTR? It is storing address of PTR. So again, when we are saying double pointer P PTR is 7, that means again I is modified to 7. Okay, so this is double reference because P PTR is pointing PTR and PTR is pointing I. Okay, that's why it is double reference. Now when it is next statement, it is now modifying the PTR to J. So instead of storing address of I, it will be storing address of J. So automatically PPTR also double pointer PPTR also points J. Okay, so when double pointer PPTR is 9, that means J will be modified to 9 now. So double pointer PPTR, it is still storing reference of PTR, which is pointing J now. Okay, and when we are saying pointer PPTR is equal to ampersand I, that means again PTR will be pointing I. Okay, and when we are saying it is equal to pointer PTR is equal to minus 2, I will be modified to minus 2. Clear? So this is a very good example to understand the double pointer concept. So we can do plus or minus 1 with the pointer, but multiplication and division is not allowed with the pointers. That is not having any meaning. Plus and minus 1, they are helpful in proceeding the pointer ahead or backwards in the array, but division and multiplication is not having any meaning. It is meaningless. Okay. So another example. So here there is float pointer PTR is equal to A. So when we are incrementing PTR by 1, that means it is incremented by 4 bytes. That is, it will be. So here our float is of 4 bytes. That's why incrementation will be of 4 bytes. Okay. Clear? So size of float will be assigned. Okay. So advantages, efficiency, and convenience while using array, and disadvantage of pointers is error prone and difficult to debug. So if you have not understood the pointer concept properly, then it will give you error which you will not be able to understand. So we'll go through the pointer arithmetic shortly. So we can have these operations with the pointers: incrementation, decrementation, addition, subtraction, a comparison of the pointers, whether two pointers they are pointing to the same memory, that we can check. Then pointers may be subtracted from each other. Why it is done? Suppose I am subtracting two pointers. What it is done? So it is useful in case of array. Suppose my one of the pointer is pointing to the first element of array and another pointer is pointing to the last element of array. So if I am subtracting from that last element's reference to the first element's reference, I will get the size of the array. How many elements are between those pointers, those two pointers? So that will give me the number of elements in that array. Okay, so subtraction is useful. Operations meaningless unless performed on an array. So all these operations are useful in case of array. Otherwise, there is no meaning. Suppose randomly any variable is stored after any variable, we don't have any meaning by when we are incrementing any random single variable. So in case of array, so suppose this is array of integers where every integer is 4 bytes. Okay, and we are storing reference of this first element, that is base address. It is also called as base address of the array. So I am storing in the pointer the location of V of 0. And suppose so VPTR is a pointer which is pointing to the array. Okay, and when I'm incrementing VPTR by 2, so it will be incremented by 4 bytes in the first and then again with 4 bytes. So When I'm incrementing this VPTR plus equal to 2, that means my VPTR will be advanced to V of 2. Okay. Is it clear? So initialization of VPTR is to the base address of the array, that is V of 0. And when we are incrementing that VPTR with plus equal to 2, so that means twice we are incrementing it. That means it will be advanced to the V of 2. Okay, clear? So this is the use of incrementation. Okay, so suppose there are two pointers. One pointer is pointing to V of 2 and another pointer VPTR is pointing to V of 0. And when we are subtracting two these both the pointers, it will be giving us 2. That is, there are two elements in between these pointers. Okay. And we can compare the pointer, whether two pointers they are pointing to the same location, or first pointer is pointing to the previous element, second pointer is pointing to the next element, like that. So we can check that. Okay, what is void pointer? You must have seen multiple times there is a void pointer. So void pointer is nothing but the pointer to the It is generic pointer which can be typecasted to any type. This void pointer can be converted to integer pointer, float pointer, or any type of pointer, and then you can use it. Okay, so you have to first, before using this void pointer, you have to typecast first. You have to assign the type to it, and then you can use it afterwards. Okay. So this is also called a generic pointer. We'll see some example related to it. Now, there is one concept called constant qualifier, const qualifier. Okay, so what is constant? You must have seen in C++, there is concept of constant. Constant is variable which cannot be changed. Okay, so this const keyword is used in case of you want a variable which should not be changed. Okay, so use const if function does not need to change a variable. Attempting to change a const will give you error. Similarly, so const is used with variables. Similarly, const can be used with pointers also. How? So it should, suppose I want a pointer which should constantly point to that memory only. Okay, it should not point to any other memory location. It should point to that particular memory space only. Then this const keyword is useful for me. Okay, so it points to the constant memory location and must be initialized when declared. The constant pointers must be initialized when declared. So there are three different variations given. Just go through it. Three examples: int pointer, const my pointer equal to ampersand x. Another variation is there, const keyword is with int. Okay, here const keyword is with my ptr, but here const variable is with int. And there is another version where const keyword is attached to both int also and p pointer also. Now, what is the meaning or difference between these three? So, for the first example, the const keyword is attached to a pointer variable. So, here type integer pointer const, it is constant pointer to, yes, it is constant pointer to integer. Okay, so it will be always pointing to integer. In the second version, it is regular pointer to const int. Okay, it is regular pointer to const int. So in the first case, the pointer is pointing to that pointer is always pointing to x. Okay, that pointer is always pointing to x. In the second version, that pointer is always pointing to integer. Okay, any integer, it is always pointing to integer. And in the third case, here const pointer to a constant integer, so that integer also is fixed, that will not be modified, and the pointer is also fixed, that will be always pointing to x. Okay, so there is this here, the last one is the exact bonding between these two, PTR and x, that is the strict bonding between two. So PTR cannot point to any other integer, and it cannot have any other value also. X cannot have any other value also. It is constantly having that particular integer. Okay. So const keyword can be used to fix the memory location of the pointer. Okay. Now, example of this const concept. In this case, there are two integers x and v, and initially we have a pointer, constant pointer, which is storing x. And what we are doing, we are modifying pointer PTR to 7. That means value of x will be modified to 7. And we are saying PTR is equal to ampersand v. But this will produce an error because PTR is having constant, it is constantly pointing to x, and it should not point to any other variable. It should always point to x. Okay. So this will produce an error. It will not be executed properly. One minute. So is this example clear? Yes. If you have any doubt, you can ask. This one doubt is there. What if we declare x is equal to 7? There is no problem. So here, const keyword is with pointer. So our pointer is fixed. It should always point to x here in this case. Okay. So x can be modified. There will not be any problem with that. Any other doubt? Okay. Go slow. Okay. I was, a little bit fast because I thought some of the basics about the pointers were covered in Siddharth's lecture. That's why. Okay, and I'll share this presentation with you so that you can go through the different examples. And most of the examples given are from pointers in C book. So I will refer you if you get any online copy or from library. If you get it, please solve multiple examples from that book. Okay, so we'll cover the other part in the next lecture. If you have any doubt in this particular thing, you can ask me. Okay, so what we have seen in today's lecture, how to allocate memory for a pointer. Okay, how to use the pointer. We will see in detail how to use pointers with arrays and structures in the next part. Okay, and also we will see with functions how pointers can be used. So that we have to see in detail. So simple basic arithmetic of related to pointer that we covered today. Okay, what arithmetic is possible? Incrementation, decrementation, plus minus, and that is in case of array. If it is pointer to array, then there is meaning of doing all this arithmetic. Otherwise, there is no meaning of incrementing or decrementing the pointer. Okay, so if we go through the advantages of pointer, this dynamic memory allocation is a very important advantage, and we will discuss call by reference and in our assignment, first assignment, which we will discuss in the afternoon for C1 and C2 batches. I think they have practical today, FDS practical. So we'll discuss related to array in the practical session today. Okay. And this linked list, etc., we will be covering in the fourth unit onwards. Okay. So as we will go on implementing the concept, this will be clear to you. Okay. Now I am just going through the presentation, and I think I have shared presentation of Akshay where some of the examples are discussed. Okay, so I'll again request all of you to go through it. Okay, these examples we have seen. Okay, the PPTs I will share whatever part we have covered today that I will put on the Google Classroom today itself. Can assign the address of variable by our preference. Yes, we can assign the address of the variable. That is the use of the pointer. With our preference. Yes, as we have done in this example. We have assigned the address of the pointer by our own here. So initially it was PTR was pointing to I. Then after that it was pointing to J, like this. So as we want, we can ask the pointer to point the particular variable, no problem. Mrutul has some question. I mean that if the result will be same 7, then will it still give error? See, error is not for assigning for 7 in that example. That was for changing the pointer location. We'll see some another examples also. I'll just go to that particular slide. Okay, this one here. See, error was not for this. You can assign 7 to the pointer, no problem. But you cannot ask PTR to point to Y. Okay, PTR will always point to X. Whatever is the value of X, PTR should always point to X. It should not be asked to point to another variable because it is a constant pointer. So it will be always pointing to X. Okay. Any other problem? Yes. You say that address of A of 0 is 1000. So we can assign directly that array A will begin from 1000. Yes, if we know that array is stored at 1000, then we can assign the address, but no need of knowing the address. You can directly use ampersand sign. So when you say pointer integer pointer PTR is equal to ampersand A, okay, or ampersand A of 0, so that will give us the base address. Okay, so we will learn that in the next session when we are going to see arrays and pointers in detail, how to use pointer with array. In that we will discuss it in more detail. Okay, so what was the outcome of today's session? You should be able to learn to declare the pointer, to assign the value to the pointer, and you should know which type of pointer will work on which variables. Okay, that was the outcome of today's session. In the next session, in detail, we are going to see how to use pointers with arrays, how to do incrementation, decrementation with arrays using pointer. And in the first assignment, set assignment, we are going to apply it also. Okay, so in set operations, we will have certain functions without pointer and certain functions with pointers. Okay. So in today's practical, we will discuss this without pointer, arrays without pointer, how to pass it to function, etc. Okay. So my request is to that you should revise arrays before you come for the today's practical. Okay. Because I will not go through the theory part that much regarding array, regarding pointer that we are going to see. But what is array, how to declare array, how much memory to allocate, that things must be clear to you before you come for the today's session. Okay? Any other doubt? Yes, we can decrement the address. Will it not affect the other address of other variable? The decrementing pointer will not affect anything. You are going to that particular location and you are accessing that. But what is that particular variable, that particular address storing, that you are not knowing? Maybe it is storing some system variables. Maybe it is storing some other program's variables. You can access, but you cannot modify every time. If you are modifying that, you are then you are losing the actual contents, actual important variables. So you have to take care when you are handling the pointers. You have to take care. You have to be sure whether you are accessing the memory which you want, or you are accessing any other memory which we are not expected to handle. Okay, that care you have to take always. Okay, so even if we can do, there is no meaning of doing it. Any other doubt? This PPT I would like to share with you. So in the next session we will see in detail how to use pointers with arrays and strings, etc., with functions. And yes, this one. So instructions or references, practice the problem, as many problem statements you can practice from literacy and pointers in C. Okay, so there are many examples given in that pointers in C book. If you are practicing those, I'm very sure you will be very confident of using pointers. Okay, and I have taken the examples for my presentation. Most of the examples are from pointers in C book or literacy book. Okay, so shall we stop here? If I have any of these books, then I will share. Actually, I am also not having the soft copies at this moment. So if I get the soft copies, I will.